Shout out to Interbay Air Compressors down there in Tampa. Years ago, I bought a badass, big ass compressor. It's a 9000 Sailor Bay or, hold on one second, let's ask him.
Sealer Bay.
Years ago, I bought a 9000, I don't know what the 9000 has to do with, but I think it's like $9,000 for just the pump on this compressor.
Oh,
that's a fact. And it had a 25 horsepower electric pump on it. Let me rephrase that. It had a 25 horsepower electric motor on it. So the motor turns with belts, run to pulleys, and turns the pump and builds compression and builds air in the tank, which was plenty to power my whole shop. I will never try preventative maintenance ever again. I knew I had belts somewhere in 18,000 square feet. Sure as hell, I actually put my eyes on these things when I went looking for them. So I figured, well, the belts are squealing, let's put on the new belts. Fast forward to almost losing a finger in the pulley with the belts. Finally muscle on three belts. The guy holding the camera right now, myself and my buddy John. So I tell Bradley, the guy holding the camera right now, go ahead and turn on the power. Flips that switch and it's purring. It's turning those belts, everything's perfect. For about 3 seconds until the guy holding the camera looks outside and goes, Ryan, as I'm jumping up and down, I think I was doing cartwheels at some point. What are the sparks? I look back, very funny, Bradley. Holy shit, turn it off, turn it off. I seized a $4,000 electric motor in a matter of 3 seconds. It was almost a legitimate 3 seconds because I almost lost my pinky. So here we are, yeah. Interbay Air Compressors. Bill, you the man, buddy. He sent me to a repair place. I called that repair place. I called Bill right back. I said, Bill, I can't afford your repair place. They rebuilt a 30 horsepower electric motor and my dudes over here, Steve-O and Nick, are swapping this thing out right now. So let's go bother them. Should I pick this up in view? I'd be like, everybody saw this wear.
What'd you do?
Oh, fuck. I hereby solemnly swear to never attempt preventative maintenance on a compressor ever again. Apparently there's such a thing as belts can be too tight. Who would have thought?
They look like halves.
Don't show this.
Well,
they're gonna start to think
that.
I don't know what I'm doing. Call this walking the dog. Came over here on the forklift was my forklift license. All I had was my EBT card. We're gonna go find something to do.
Yes, sir.
All right, guys. So as a metal shop owner of 22 years, I can tell you there is never a dull moment. So this morning we dealt with catastrophic electric motor repair on the compressor with my buddy Steve and my buddy Nick. Shout out to Bill over there at Interbay Air Compressors down in Tampa. That's the dude you want to buy your compressor from. And here we are now, one stop to the next. We're at a U-Haul. We got to get something. We got to haul ass to Ruskin and bring something back to the sleigh ground that everybody I think is going to enjoy. So let's go.
So for those viewing, I mean, let's hit you with it now.
Why do you have a U-Haul, Ryan?
When I say Rob Dyrdek's Fantasy Factory, what is the first thing that comes to mind? Besides from being one of the baddest skateboarders in the world. First thing, what is it? Don't want to overfill, every dollar counts. You never want to return it with more than what you got. This bitch only had an 8 tank.
You carry it away, sir.
In, hands and toes.
I've always wanted to slide on the hood.
I'll tell you what, Super Duties are super nice. Only got 149,000 miles.
Handles like a dream. Hey, there's our fellow box truck.
Hey, Bradley. There's a bald guy. You know him?
Of course.
GPS off.
You got it, man. Think corners like it's on rails.
So keep your camera rolling, okay? Because the text message I received said just pull around back, so we might be getting jumped. I see what we've done.
I see. Look at that.
That looks like it's back flippable.
Oh, I think we made it. I did that on
purpose. Any last words?
Let's go load some stuff.
Truck we needed, not this little 15 footer. Look how good he looks. There's no extra bagster strapped onto the back door. I bet he didn't forget about the hand truck and have to strap that onto the bagster as well. Come
plenty
on, John.
Leg room.
Bradley, put the formula for volume on the bottom of the screen, or here. Put it right here. Playground. Cargo made it too. Did you show them how we strapped that stuff up? I have to pee.
I can't believe we made it.
I'm gonna give you another hint as to what's in the U-Haul. It's soft. No fantasy factory is complete without a foam pit.
I mean, some of them are neatly square. I mean, somebody took way too much time on it. And his name was Chen.
Yeah.
He was fucking awesome. Chen is a man.
Now for real.
Come on. Holy shit. Oh,
tried to warn you.
Holy shit. You guys got a lot of foam here. We were planning on filling a trampoline so that it was easy keeping.
You're gonna need two more trampolines.
That's what Brad said too.
More in the cab, by the way, guys.
Really? Damn manual cranks, you Ford guys. It's okay if I scratch it. I put $14 worth of insurance on it.
Like a glove.
All right, so we're back. The foam's unloaded. Now we do the next part of our day at 9 o'clock at night. Now we finish up a medical order and deliver it in the morning. Come on, Bradley.
Come on, boss!